Those parents who didn't allow my kid to use a different pronoun. And well, guess what happened to my kid? He pulled up in an ambulance for trying to take his life because I was not on board with that.
A mother weighing in on a debate over pronouns with her personal story meant to educate people in the DeWitt Public School District. Tonight, it was the first board meeting since controversy erupted over a plan to teach elementary students about pronouns. Good evening, I'm Ann Emmerich. The district scrapped that lesson just days after announcing it last month. News 10's Jordan Burrell joins us live in the newsroom to tell us about this ongoing pronoun debate.
Hi, Ann. Parents and community members came to the meeting by the dozens, some in support of the school district's efforts of inclusivity, others saying children, and especially first graders, should not be learning about gender pronouns in school.
But the truth is, teaching seven-year-olds to lie at the command of an adult to protect someone else is abuse. And when those lies and abuse are over a sexualized issue, there's a word for that too, grooming.
When we heard the news of this lesson being canceled, we were very disappointed. I might get a little emotional.
A battle between two sides. Allow inclusion into schools by teaching children about pronouns or allow their parents to do it at home. On April 11th, the DeWitt Public Schools superintendent sent a letter to parents about the lesson called They, She, He, Me, Free to Be, that included teaching children about pronoun use and genders. The optional lesson was ultimately canceled days later after backlash.
Teaching our children that they can sit there and pick their own gender. Very sad what's going on today. Very sad.
And I think about the opportunity to kind of educate their peers, and then that opportunity was taken away.
Other members of the community arguing this is not a conversation that should be had at school.
I believe the statistic is 1 in 6 students are graduating illiterate. Do we really have time to be teaching such an elective course?
And despite interruptions from the crowd, Superintendent Shannon Spickard confirms that their students are fine and the district will continue to work through a solution that is best fit for everyone.
Our students are excelling and they are doing a great job, and there's a lot of false information about proficiency and graduation rates. Our graduations are in the high 90s. Our students are excelling at our target of 80% being average or higher. Our proficiency scores are above state and county averages.
Throughout the entire ordeal, Superintendent Spickard revealed that multiple school staff members had received numerous online threats and even their information doxed on social media. She says majority of those came from people outside of the DeWitt community and began increasing security at the schools. Live in the newsroom, I'm Jordan Burrell, News 10.